Our next speaker is Dr. Chrispus Kiyonga, who is a federal minister and national political commissioner under the office of the president. He also served as a minister of health, a minister of trade, a minister of internal affairs, a minister of finance, and chairperson of global funds for AIDS, TB, and malaria. Dr. Chrispus is a great supporter of the Jamaat projects, raises the issue of persecution of Ahmadis in Parliament. It gives me great pleasure to ask him to come and say a few words.
Your Eminence, the Supreme Head of the Ahmadiyya Muslim Community, Your Eminences, the religious leaders, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, may peace and blessings and favors be upon you all. I'm indebted to the Almighty God who has, through His grace, enabled me to address this magnificent and historical convention. My deep appreciation goes to the Supreme Head of the Ahmadiyya Muslim Community, who, out of his generosity, invited me to participate in this convention. Thank you very much, Your Holiness. I have learned with deep appreciation that the Supreme Head of the community is involved in the promotion of peace worldwide. In addition, the Supreme Head is involved in promotion of justice, love, and tolerance amongst all mankind. On my behalf and on behalf of the government and people of Uganda, I thank Your Holiness for this great work you are tirelessly doing for the people of God. Yesterday, I listened carefully to Your Holiness as you addressed the convention. I further had the opportunity to meet Your Holiness in your office. You are emphatic and clear that those who claim to kill in the name of religion and God should be condemned. This is a very important message and instruction to all of us attending this very important convention. We should all take this message to our brothers and sisters in the countries we come from. The world is witnessing untold atrocities all over the world, from Africa to the Arab Gulf and to Europe. The terrorists are killing, maiming, and displacing innocent people, including children, women, the elderly, and the people with disabilities. Under the leadership of His Excellency Yoweri Museveni, the President of the Republic of Uganda, we have re-established peace and stability in our country after many years of untold suffering inflicted upon our people by insurgents, including those who claim to kill in the name of religion and God. Among these are the so-called Allied Democratic Forces of Jamil Mukulu, who reside in the Democratic Republic of Congo. This organization claims to be a fundamentalist Islamic organization. It has killed so many people in Uganda and the Democratic Republic of Congo. It engages in the recruitment of young people and radicalizing them so that they become ruthless killers of fellow human beings. We also have the Al-Shabaab, who have caused mayhem in Somalia, Kenya, and Uganda, among other countries where these terrorists and heartless people have killed so many people. In Uganda, as an example, they killed 70 people one night who were watching the World Football Match on TV in 2010. The government of Uganda, in collaboration with other African states, has deployed soldiers to hunt down the Al-Shabaab in Somalia. I request this convention to pray for the people of Somalia so that these people of God may also know sustainable peace, which has been denied them by the terrorists of Al-Shabaab, who claim to fight and kill in the name of religion and God. Turning specifically to the Republic of Uganda, I want to thank His Holiness for the historical visit he paid to Uganda in the year 2005. His Holiness was able to meet His Excellency Yoweri Museveni, the President of the Republic of Uganda. The happy memories of your visit are still fresh in our minds, and we look forward to your coming again to visit our country. Since your visit, a number of initiatives have been implemented in our country. The Scholarship Fund for Education has helped some poor but bright young people further their education at all levels, including university. The Vocational Institute, established in the district of Budaka in eastern Uganda, has given skills to young Ugandans. These skills have enabled the young people to be self-employed and so earn a living. The secondary school Your Holiness reopened in our capital city, Kampala, is growing day by day, some problems notwithstanding. These are just few examples of the development initiatives that the Ahmadiyya Association are undertaking in Uganda. God willing, we expect more initiatives to be established in the country. At this point, I want to request the well-to-do members of the association to come to Uganda and establish private business. Uganda, as I said before, is now a stable country. We have a lot of resources, including tourist attractions, petroleum, iron ore, phosphates, and other minerals for exploitation. We have the Nile and other rivers on which hydropower stations are being established for renewable power supply. Your Eminence, we request you to encourage the wealth members of the community to come and invest in Uganda. As I conclude, allow me to indicate that in Uganda there is freedom of worship. Accordingly, the members of the Ahmadiyya Association enjoy unhindered freedom to carry out their activities throughout our country in Uganda. Thank you very much, and may the Almighty God bless you all.
Narae Takbir! Jumaat-e-Ahmadiyya Uganda!